no kick from champagne. Mere alcohol doesn't thrill me at all. So tell me, why shouldn't it be true? I get a kick out of brew. There's only one beer left. Rappers screaming all in our ears like we're deaf. Tempt me, do a number on the label. Beat up all the MCs and drink them under the table like it's on me. Put it on my tab, kid, however you get there. Foot it, cab it, iron horse it. You leave it on your face, forfeit. Across the mic, hold it like the heat, he might toss it. Told her, tell him they stole it. He told her he lost it. She told him, get off it and a bunch of other more. Getting money, DTs be getting no new leads. It's like eating watermelon, stay spitting new seeds. It's the weed, give me some of what he drooping on. As soon as he wake up, choking like it was whooping cough. They grouping soft. First hour at the open bar and they trooping off. He went to go laugh, he gets a head by the side road. She asked him autograph a derriere red to wide load. This yard bird tastes like fried toad. Turn up villain, take pride in cold words. Crooked eye mode, nerd geek with a cold heart. Probably still be speaking in rhymes as an old fart. Study how to eat to die by the pizza guy. No, he's not too fly to skeet in a skeezer eye.
There are two main kinds of internal combustion engines. First of all, you have the pistons. Those are the ones that go up and down. They're in like 99% of cars on the road. And then you have like those one really niche ones called rotaries. And they're pretty cool, I guess. They work on the same principle in which you combust a fuel and air mixture and that generates a rotative force. And then rotaries are like kind of a niche thing. I don't know. It might be cool for like a series of sports cars or something. I don't know. Japanese street racing really took off in the 90s. They had Initial D, Wank, At Midnight, a ridiculously sick lineup of affordable sports cars, and even some borderline supercars. Highway, Drift, Touge, all of it. The Mazda RX-7 is one of the most influential sports cars ever. It's in the same ranks as the Corvette, the Skyline GTR, and even the Suzuki Cappuccino. Okay, maybe not that one, but definitely the Honda Beat. Flashback to the 1930s, and the Empire of Japan was rapidly expanding for resources. I mean, it was war crimes left, right, and center, and they knew that eventually the United States would intervene. So they decided to do a preemptive strike on Pearl Harbor's submarine yards, aircraft carriers, and oil. Judging by an image like this, you might think, oh, Japan obviously won this one, but they actually didn't because they missed the oil, they missed the submarines, and those carriers were actually arriving late. So they really just did a good job pissing off America. Oops. Looks like they sunk one of your aircraft carriers. Oh, wait, no. The U.S. actually sunk four aircraft carriers in 5 days. The United States often has a habit of expressly delivering freedom to wherever on the globe within a week. And now you've let them do it. Completely unprohibited. It only took 18 P-38s to gun down Admiral Yamamoto's plane in 1942. In 1943, when they started invading your islands, the commander in charge of the island of Tarawa said, "A million men cannot take Tarawa in 100 years. And, you know, he was right. It actually didn't take a million men 100 years. It took 18,000 Marines 4 days. So he got the Americans into closer, the Russians pushing it from north, and what's this? The U.S. has a new plane. It's called the F-6F Hellcat. It shoots down 19 of our planes for every one we shoot down. They have 12,275 Hellcats.
They made our new one.
What the hell is a super fortress?
What's a marauder?
They're calling their planes.
The U.S. just saved the largest battleship ever?
Are you telling me that they're firebombing?
Are you telling me they can level a city with a singular bomb?
Are you telling me they leveled a city with a singular bomb?
Are you telling me they leveled another city with a singular bomb? Are you telling me they're gonna level Tokyo if we don't surrender? Are you telling me the Russians are gonna level Tokyo?
After 9 years of occupation by the United States, Japan was now a strong ally. And, naturally, as an emerging power with a democratic government, they start making things, right? Like a lot of things. Now, to the 1960s, they're making hella cars, and one brand in particular is ready to launch their very first sports car, and they've decided to use a rotary engine.
Rappers are monkey flipping with the funky rhythm. I be kicking, musician, inflicting composition. A pain, I'm like Scarface sniffing, holding the M16. See with the pen, I'm extreme. Now, bullet holes left in my peak holes. I'm suited up with street clothes. Hand me a 9 and out the feet flow.
The Mazda Cosmo was pretty good for Mazda's first attempt at making a sports car. However, they knew it wasn't enough. So in 1972, they released a car called the RX3. Basically, imagine the RX3 is an American muscle car, except instead of consisting on a diet of, like, you know, fries and burgers, it ate purely rice and, like, lost, like, 15 pounds. But again, you know, more money. They want more money, so they decide, we're going to build another rotary sports car. The Mazda RX-7 FB, released in 1979, is sort of a crossbreed. You see, it's got some early 80s design, but it's also got some late 70s stuff in there. Like the wheels. Like, the wheels aren't very 80s, but the pop-up headlights are. Which is why it's kind of a weird zone, but it did a lot for Mazda. Of course, not as much as its younger brother, the FC. The Mazda RX-7 FC might be one of the most 1980s cars ever designed. It became an integral cornerstone of the Japanese tuning community. But frankly, all these cars have been leading up to Mazda's magnum opus. The reason why we're all here. The Mazda RX-7 FD. Or, we can heavily modify our RX-7 beyond the point of recognition, basically making it Kim Kardashian. Me, personally, I think it should be a crime, punishable by death. Anyways, this brings me to my point, right? And it's that rotary engines, although they do consume a decent amount of fuel, actually don't weigh very much for the amount of power they produce. These engines have the displacement of like 3 water bottles and they are producing 276 horsepower. What I'm getting at is that it shouldn't be hard in the year 2024 to construct a lightweight car that uses a rotary engine and is affordable, which is why I proposed this design to Mazda for a small, lightweight, fuel-efficient, and affordable rotary engine car. Please hire me, Mazda. Please. Not only is this helping save the environment, but it's also fulfilling the UNSDG's goals for a sustainable future. So, you're helping the environment, you're helping the United Nations, you're helping me. You're helping yourself. We're helping everyone. It's a moral good. Give me your money.